हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड सेवेंथ इन केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 5 एसिड बेसेस एंड सॉल्ट्स। इन द बिगिनिंग वी लर्न दैट द सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच टेस्ट श्योर इन टेस्ट श्योर दे आर एसिड्स and we can say that they are acidic in nature, like lemon juice, tamarind, orange, then raw mango and vinegar, etc. And the substances which are bitter in taste and soapy in touch, they are the bases, and those are known as basic substances. Now we also learn that we understand a question also. We learn that we mustn't taste or touch any unknown substances unless you are asked to do it, because if unknown acids and bases are there, maybe they will be harmful. So without tasting, that how can we decide whether they are acids or bases? And for that also we learn that the indicators are used. They are also known as acid-base indicators. These indicators use different color with acid and bases. So according to the color change, without tasting it, we can decide whether the given solution is acidic or basic in nature. And as I told you, they are known as indicators. The common indicators used are the litmus papers, or simply a litmus. Now, they are natural indicators. So, today we are going to learn about some natural indicators around us. Means that we can obtain from the nature, and then we can use them as the indicators, like are they acidic substances or basic substances. Now, as I told you that the most common indicator used is the litmus. Now, this litmus is extracted from lichens. Lichens is available from some plants, and it looks like this in figure. This is the lichen. So when we take the lichen and dissolve it in the distilled water, it gives mauve, means purple color. So the color of the litmus solution that we obtain from lichen made in the distilled water, then it gives the purple color. But if you add few drops of this in base or acid, they will give different color. In an acidic solution, it turns red. So if you put few drops of this litmus solution in acid, in any acidic solution like lemon juice or vinegar or orange juice, then that purple color will change into red color. But if you add it to basic solutions, then it gives blue color, means it turns from purple to blue color. For example, you put the few soap or some other basic materials like baking soda, etc., then it will give you blue color. So by adding the few drops of litmus solution, we can easily check whether the given solution is acidic in nature or basic in nature. And this litmus is also generally available in blue and red litmus papers. The strips of litmus papers are available in market, in which they are selling this laboratory equipments and chemicals, etc. So there are red and blue litmus paper. They look like this. Blue litmus paper and red litmus paper. So it is available as a solution also, and as I show you that they are available in red and blue litmus papers also. How can we use the litmus papers? When we put blue and red both the litmus paper in acidic solution, then blue litmus paper will turn into red, but there will be no color change in a red litmus paper. Similarly, when you put blue and red litmus papers in the solution of base, then it will turn the red litmus paper into blue, but no color change will be experienced in the blue litmus paper. So actually you can remember a shortcut to remember the color change of litmus in acid and base. Then you can remember for litmus papers. What you have to remember? A, Br, and B, Rb. What is the meaning of Abr and Brb? Abr means acids turn the blue litmus into red, and bases turns red litmus into blue. So Abr, Brb. That shortcut, if you will keep in your mind, speak it so many times, repeat it, Abr, Brb, Abr, Brb. Then all of a sudden, if somebody asks you what happens if blue litmus paper and red litmus paper are dipped in a acidic solution. Acid, then you have to remember A means Bia, means blue litmus paper which turns into red. So that will be a very very important thing that you have to remember. So now, as I told you, that acid turns blue litmus into red and basis turns red litmus paper into blue. So by this color change, we can determine the nature of the given unknown solutions, that either they are basic in nature or acidic in nature. So without tasting or touching them, we can use this acid base indicators. Now there are some other substances are also there which will show no color change to litmus. It means that if we dip both red litmus paper and blue litmus paper in their solution, there will be no color change. So if a substance give no color change with litmus, then they are known as neutral solution. Look here. The solutions which do not change the color of either red or blue litmus are known as neutral solutions. For example, if you take salt solution, sugar solution, dissolved salt in water or sugar in water, then if you dip the red and blue litmus paper, the red will remain red, blue will remain blue only. There will be no color change. It means that these solutions are neutral solutions. Means they are neither acidic in nature nor basic in nature. So that is the fact about the litmus solution and blue and red litmus papers. Not only litmus, but some other indicators are also natural indicators. So which are the other natural acid base indicators? So the other acid base natural indicators are turmeric and China rose petal solution. Turmeric, haldi, jene apne Gujarati ma haldar kahiye, which we use for the flavor and taste in our food items. That is also a natural indicator. We can make turmeric paper and dip them to taste whether the acidic or basic solutions are there. How can we make these papers? We have to take some turmeric powder and by adding little water make a paste. Don't add too much water that it can be watery, just to make the paste. And then take the blotting paper which are available in the laboratories and put this paste on it and rub it little and then remove it. Then you will see that floating paper will turn into that yellow color and make the strip like that litmus paper I show you. That size of strip you can cut it and we can use them as indicators. Now this turmeric paper, we can use it. Generally what happens, they give color change with the basic solution. If they are dipped into basic solution, they will turn red from yellow. Generally, you know the turmeric is of yellow color. Maybe you have noticed sometimes you have some patches of food items on your white shirt while eating time. Maybe a curry, vegetables curry, in which the turmeric is there. And when you wash it with the soap, then that patches will become red. Why? Because red. Why it is turning red? Because the turmeric turns from yellow to red with base. And we know that soap are the basic solution. So if you try to wash that patches of that curry or the vegetable curry on your shirt or any clothes, and if you wash it with the soap, it turns red because of this color change of turmeric. So we can use this turmeric paper if you taste it. You can make lime water also. Lime water also basic solution. How can we make lime water? For that we have to take some lime, means chuna, that we used to whitewash the walls. Take little chuna and dissolve in water, stir it in water. Then let it get steady. Then some of the chuna will settle down. And from that, you can decant the supponent, that water from the top. That is the lime water. And lime water, named as calcium hydroxide, which is a basic solution. So if you put this turmeric in it, it will also turn red because of the basic nature of the lime water. And as shown in this picture, with using this turmeric paste, we can make colored birthday card for somebody also, because it gives different color with base. So you can apply the turmeric paste on the sheet of paper, white paper, and get it dry. Let it get dry. So it is a turmeric paper. And now, draw beautiful flower with soap solution. Take the earbuds and dip it in the soap solution. And with that earbuds, you can draw a beautiful flower or anything. Then it will turn red on the turmeric paper. So you can make a beautiful greeting card also using that turmeric and soap solution also. Then the other is the China rose petal solution. It is also a natural indicator. What we have to do, we have to take some China rose petals and take them in a beaker and add some warm water in it, and then keep the mixture for some time. Then you will see that the water will become colored water. That will be generally color will be little pink color. Now you can use this solution, mean the petal solution, as an indicator. How? Because it gives a different color in different type of solution, acid and base. Generally, it turns dark pink or magenta color in acidic solution and it turns green in basic solution. So when you add them, few drops of this China rose petal solution in acid, then it turns dark pink or the magenta color, and with base it will turn in green color. So these are the natural indicators. There are some synthetic also, means man-made, like phenolphthalein, methyl orange, which are used in laboratory. About that you will learn in the next session. So we are going to stop the session, and any problem write down in the comment section and write down whatever you got in PDF file in your notebook. Thank you very much.